Hi, it's Andy from KRÜSS. So in this video, we're going to get a bit more hands-on with Tensíío, and we're going to take a look at one of the core measurements you can do with the instrument. In fact, we're going to look at what tensiometry is really named for, measuring surface tension of liquids. Now, it's often the way that the simplest questions are the hardest ones to answer. And a question I get asked a lot is, why do we want to measure surface tension in the first place? Now, this is trickier than it sounds, because in truth, there are dozens and maybe even hundreds of different reasons why you would need to know the surface tension of a liquid. In short, surface tension is a fundamental property, just like viscosity or density, and it's critical for formulating any kind of liquid-based product, like an ink or a shampoo or lubrication or medication or an adhesive. And surface tension can also be used to determine fluid dynamic properties, like, for instance, the volume of a drop falling from a nozzle. Now, let's get started with the hands-on session. So, in our lab, one of the most common uses of surface tension measurements is to assess the cleanliness of solid parts that our customers have sent to us for testing. In particular, this kind of test is a critical step when we begin a new troubleshooting project. And that means when something is not working properly, or perhaps there's some kind of product failure, we need to find out the cause of that. And we need to, first of all, find out if contamination could be the underlying problem. This is especially useful if you have a production process that involves, say, a cleaning step, like a cleaning bath, or maybe you're taking parts straight out of production and you need to know that there isn't any detergent residue left on the surface. Now, the reason these measurements work here is because surface tension is a really sensitive parameter, and I can use that fact to detect even small amounts of contamination. To do this, I first need to check the surface tension of my pure water as a reference, so I can take some water here, and I can check that it's really clean. First, what I need to do is move over to advance. I first want to open a surface tension measurement. So I can move across here and I'll select Wilhelmy surface tension. And I can open up my predefined water test template that I've made before. Once we're in the measurement method, I can now set up all the parameters I need to. In this case, I don't really need to do much because everything has been pre-programmed for me. The measurement procedure itself has been set up already. All that I really need to do is tell advance a name for my measurement. So in this case, I'll call it before wash. And I need to tell it what liquid I'm going to be testing. So I can click here and search for water. Now everything's pretty much set up. All I have to do is scroll down and press on the start automation button. As soon as I do that, advance then gives me a prompt with a series of instructions on what I need to do to get the measurement ready. So we can go over and do that now. In this case, I'm going to be measuring with what's called a Wilhelmy plate. Now, there are different options you can use for this. The Wilhelmy plate itself is a rectangular plate of platinum, and it's probably the most commonly used sample probe today. There are other alternatives, like, for instance, the Denoy ring, which works in very much the same way. One of the most important things before doing a ring or a plate measurement is that we first have to activate and clean the surface of the plate. And we can do that first by washing it with some, say, distilled water, which I have here. And then I need to heat it up to activate it. So I can use a gas burner. And I want to heat it up until the plate is just starting to glow red hot. It doesn't need to be white hot. And I just let it cool down a little bit too. Now that it's ready, I can put it into Tensíío, attach it to the force sensor. And I can move to the next step in advance. So if I look over at the screen, the next step is to fill in my sample into a sample vessel. And for this case, I'm just using doubly distilled water. I can pour it into a clean sample vessel here and place it onto the sample stage. And now the next step is to move the sample or the liquid, the water, very close to the probe. Right, so I need to use the button here at the front of Tensíío, and if I press in and turn the control, I can move a little bit faster. And I can bring it up until the two are very, very close together. And actually you can use, from this angle, you can use the reflection of the plate on the water surface to see how close you are. So if I make some fine adjustments, I'm just there. And what I'm going to do in this case is I'm going to save this position for later so I can quickly reach this position again in the future. So I can just go onto the settings here on the touch panel and save the position. Now that's all that's left to do is to go back into Advance. It tells me I need to make sure the doors are closed on my instruction box. They're closed, so I can press OK and the measurement will begin. Now Advance will run through the predefined steps I've put into my automation program. So first it's going to unlock the force sensor, then it's going to zero so that I have a fresh data set to collect. And we can see on the live display, the force sensor jumps to zero as it's done that tearing. Once it's done with that, it will wait for stabilization so that there's no vibration around in my area. And that beep tells me it's going to start measuring. We can see in Advance that it starts to get the results in live. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I've got my results already. And here on the left, they're plotted as individual results and on the right as a graph. Moving further down, now that the measurement is finished, we have a summary to the left where I can see the mean surface tension of my water is 71.2. And on the right, I have a validation step. So in this measurement, I've programmed that my surface tension of my water, which should normally have by literature value a surface tension of 72 or more, I'm setting a threshold of 70. So I need my water to have a value of higher than 70, and the standard deviation, the changing of this number, should not be greater than 1. And we can see it's green and green, so it's passed both of those in this case. Now we can move to the second part of the measurement. So first I want to take out the sample that I've just measured. So I can open up Tensíío, and I want to move the sample stage down, so I can do that from the controls here. Tell it to move down. I can take out my water. I'm not going to pour my water away because I know I now have clean water in this sample vessel. So I know the surface tension value as it is. At this point, I can take out my solid sample that I want to test. This is a PMMA plate. And what I'm going to do, I can take the water that I just tested and I can just run it over the surface of my PMMA plate. And by doing this, the water itself will pick up contamination that might be on the sample, any of the detergent or surfactant or surface active agents on the surface. So I can take this water now and put it back in my sample vessel. And I want to see, has my surface tension changed between the first measurement and now a second measurement? And of course, before I start any new measurement, like before, I need to prepare my plate again. So I can take this out. I'll just quickly rinse it with some water. And again, that important step is to heat up the sample, to burn it a bit, just until it starts to glow red. Give it a few seconds to cool down. And now I can put it back into the balance, into the force sensor. And I'm ready to go back over to advanced now. Now, I could go back to the start and make a new measurement like I did before, because I want to do a repeat of what I did. But actually, what's quicker is if I click here, I can duplicate my first measurement, so make an exact copy. The benefit here is all of the details I gave in the first measurement are now included here, so it already knows they'll be measuring water, for instance. I'll just change the name, so it will be after wash. And now I can start the automation. Again, I get that box reminding me of all the steps I need to go through. So clean the probe, I've already done. I've filled in my sample already, but I do still need to move my sample close to the bottom of my sample probe. So again, I go back to the instrument, and because we saved the position before, I don't need to move it manually. I can just tell Tensíío to go back to where it needs to be. And it stops just before it touches the surface though. Now all that's left to do is to press OK and the measurement will start running. And again, Advanced is now going to run through all the steps of that template just as it did before. So it will open the, it will unlock the force sensor and it will zero, it will stabilize, make sure that there's no vibrations from the environment. And then when we hear the beep, it will start measuring. And already I'm getting my first data in. And again, to the left side here, I have my table of data, and to the right, I have my graph. But if I go down to my summary, we can see the surface tension of this water is now significantly reduced. Remember, before it was around 71 millinewtons per meter. Now it's dropped to 59, so it's actually quite low. And that's telling me that I've picked up some contamination from the surface, so I know my PMMA plate is not clean. And even that shows up here in the validation step, where now it's lighting up red because the surface tension is not higher than 70. Okay, and that concludes the measurements for this surface tension video. I hope you've enjoyed this and I look forward to seeing you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.